the approach to the truth of dukkha by the Buddha is from three aspects. You know, he was a great classifier, great teacher. He had always to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or ABC. And just imagine him seated under the trees, talking to his beloved students that dukkha or disease can be approached from three angles. It is the same sorrow, it is the same suffering, it is the same disease, but it can be approached from three angles. So one is dukkha dukkha, which I would, for the sake of convenience, say physical or external, caused by physical or external means. Sorrow brought about when you fall off your bicycle. When you escape by a hair's breadth from a Toyota. See, we are striking optimistic notes, don't think. That's a very Hindu approach, you know. And then the Buddha says, there is viparimana dukkha, the sorrow, the disease, the suffering caused by change. Yes, you can see how precise it is. During the last 10 years, for example, how many changes have taken place in our body? And he's now not talking about the suffering, the body doesn't suffer if a few hairs are lost. It is the mind. My beauty is gone. My glamour is going. And the Buddha will say, change is the nature of life. Change is the very texture of life. And he's telling all his students, this is going to happen to everyone's body. Even the littlest one, it's going to happen to one's body. And there is even a terrible saying, very much in the Buddhist strain, if you can look at even a baby's hand, you can see the wrinkles there. This is all to remind us, you know, about the urgency of it all, about the need to lead the spiritual life. And that's why the Buddha ran to the Himalayas to save not only his little boy, Rahula, but to save all little boys and girls, which mean we. And in personal relationships, for example, you know, after the initial satisfaction of novelty, after the initial satisfaction of physical newness, for everybody who bases relations on physical bonds, there is going to be lack of satisfaction, increasing lack of satisfaction, and slowly the beginning of dissatisfaction. Everywhere, I would say, I'm showing the positive side. Think about yourself, you're going to have diseased relationships. Think about those around you more, you'll have relationships of ease. You'll be at ease with everybody. Even those who may not be very nice to you, even those who may not always be kind to you, you'll be at ease. And again, that concept of being at ease is a very good one. And I would say a good test is how much at ease among people who dislike you are you? How much at ease can you be among people who maybe offend you, who sometimes criticize you? And it's a very good question. And first, therefore, is disease caused by external agents, carcinogenic agents in the atmosphere, I would say dukkha dukkha. And maybe diseases caused by anger, resentment, hostility. This is caused by agents inside in the mind. And then third, sankhara dukkha. You know, the dukkha of samskaras, conditioning. When I began to understand how many of my decisions were not taken by me, how many of my attitudes were not under my free sovereignty, I made up my mind with great difficulty, but under the inspiration of my teacher, that I wanted to live in freedom, not to be at the beck and call of my samskaras, not to be attached only to one or two people around me, but to have love for all, to be able to live in freedom wherever I went. And I want you to know that everybody can aspire for this by remembering these three aspects of dukkha: the physical, the mental, and the spiritual.